So hi friends, this is Amit and you are watching my channel Information and Educational Video. So by this short video, I will answer all your questions related to Manipal entrance test, that is when the result will be declared as the exam is over now and when the counseling will start and what is the refund policy, if you pay, will you get the refund or not, if you get, how much you will get. So I will try to cover all those things and I will also talk about the fee and a scholarship that you can get if you join Manipal College. So if you are first to my channel, please try to subscribe. We provide you all the information throughout the counseling so that you can do your counseling in a better way. And if you have any type of doubt with your counseling, you can ask me in the comment section or you can join the Instagram and WhatsApp group also so that you can ask the question directly from me. And I have already uploaded the last year cutoff video for all the campuses branch wise. You can check that. And next I will upload the video that is marks versus branch for all the campuses that is for expected this year. And this year the cutoff will rise for sure. So let's start the video. So before starting, I request you again, please try to subscribe the channel and share this video to your friends so that they can also get this information. So let's start the video. So here is the Manipal entrance test 2021 question and answer. So I will take all the questions you have asked through the comment section and Instagram and I will try to answer them as soon as possible. So what is the result date? So result will be announced around 20th of June, that is before 20 also you can get, but the result date is as I am getting the information, result will be announced around 20. You can get it at on 20 or 21st also or 19th also. So the result date will be around 20. So the next is how the result will be made, because many students have the question that different shift have different type of difficulty level. So this is similar to VIT exam, because in VIT exam also there are the different shift and different difficulty level. So internally they will do the normalization process and they will calculate the percentile, and according to that they will provide the rank. So you don't worry if your shift was hard or easy, that all will be neutralized by the process of normalization, and you will get the rank based on the percentile that will be calculated after the normalization. So you don't need to worry about anything, you will get the rank, but internally they will calculate the percentile similar to JEE mains. So what will be the counseling date? After 2 or 3 days of the announcement of the result, the counseling will start for sure. And how you will do the counseling, I will guide you through a separate video in which I will tell you how to do the choice filling and all those things I will discuss. And if you have any particular problem with yourself, you can ask in the comment section or you can join the Instagram and WhatsApp group also so that you can ask the question directly from me. So the next question is how to do the counseling. As I told you earlier, I will provide you a separate video so that you can do your counseling in a better way, because counseling is most important thing. And I would suggest if you don't have any experience of counseling, try to contact me. We have a team who will do the counseling for you on behalf of you, and you don't need to worry anything. They will guide you for everything until you got the admission. So don't worry, I will personally guide you for the process of counseling. So next is marks versus branch all campuses. So as I told you at the start of the video, I will make a separate video very soon in which I will talk about the marks versus branch of all the campuses, that is for CS in all the three campus, how much marks you need to score, and similarly for other branches also, because this year the cutoff will go to higher rank, because this is the only second or third counseling where the major BTech admission will take place, and a student will think to skip this. One reason is the high fee of this college, and second is a student might think they can get the better college or any good college later this year also. So the next point is fee and a scholarship. So for computer science, for the first year fee is for 30,000 for the main campus only I am talking about, because for the main campus I have provided the wrong information by mistake in my previous video, that is I have provided 384,000 is the fee, but the original fee is different, that is 430,000 for the first year computer science, and from second year onward you have to pay 485,000, that is 485,000, and for other branches you have to pay 335,000 for first year, and for the rest year for 430,000, that is 430,000 you have to pay. And for a scholarship information, you can watch my previous video, in that I have discussed in detail how you will get the scholarship and how much you will get the scholarship. So you can watch that video in the I button as well as in the description box. So the next point is the most important point, because every student have the he should pay the amount or not, whether he will get the refund after paying the amount or not. So here is the detailed information about the refund policy, that is if you want 100% refund, then you have to ask at least before 15 days of the last date of the admission process, and they will provide you the detail that what is the last date of the admission. So before 15 days, suppose the last date of the admission is 20th of July. So before 15 days, that means before 5th of July, you have to ask for the refund, so that you will get the 100% refund. For 90% refund, you have to ask that for less than 15 days, that is after 5th of July, but before 20th of July, you have to ask for the refund so that you will get the 90%. 80% refund, you have to ask for the refund before 5th of August, that is at least 15 days after the last date of the admission. I am just supposing the 20th July as the last date of the admission, but the original date will be different. So according to that, you can think for the dates for different refund policy. So for 50% refund, you have to ask after 15 days of the last date of the admission process. That is, if the admission date is 20th of July, then after 15 days, that is 5th of August, but less than 30 days. That means before 20th of August, you have to ask for the refund, then you will get the 50% refund. But after that, if you ask for the refund, then you will not get any type of refund. It is zero refund will be provided. So this is all about this video. Here I have talked about all your questions that you have asked about the Manipal Entrance Test 2021. So hope you find this video very useful. And if you have any type of doubt after watching this video, you can ask in the comment section so that I can take those questions in my next video, or I will try to answer in the comment section itself. And if you don't have any type of experience of counseling, then don't take any type of risk if you are not confident enough about the counseling. So try to join the Instagram and WhatsApp group so that I can suggest you best possible thing for the counseling, so that your counseling will be done carefully and you will get best out of your rank. So thanks for watching this video. Try to subscribe the channel so that you will get all the further update about the Manipal entrance test also, and when the result will be announced, I will try to inform you as soon as possible. So thanks for watching this video.